I was too deep into playing a role that was Phillip Edward Van Lear. The actor, the performer, the ladies' man. And the reality was that my life was anything but smooth. I was born in Aurora, Illinois. Grew up in the church. In 1965, that summer, I was baptized. I accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior. I had plenty of male figures in the church, but that wasn't enough just to keep me focused, to keep me on the right path. Way too many girls, way too many drugs, way too many parties to worry about than trying to be an obedient young Christian. I knew full well that I was walking away. I mean, it was a conscious decision. So much of my identity in the world was based on my success as an artist, as an actor. It's pervasive. Anything goes. What happens backstage stays backstage. What happens on the road stays on the road. Being alone with women, of texting women, of having emails with women, of being in coffee shops and bars, and being in my third marriage, abusing emotionally my wife, Heather. She said, look, either you are going to seek professional help or you are packing your bags. Went to get help. At first time I stepped in that psychiatrist's office, I remember asking me, she said, so how do you feel? And I said, what do you mean? She said, well, do you feel normal? I said, I don't know. I don't know what normal is. And she says, well, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say your anxiety is about an 8. And then on the scale of 1 to 10, your depression, it's about a 9.5. I just remember the floodgates, like, just, you don't have it all together. You aren't this strong black man, you know, that's just going to be able to bowl his way through, just bow his back and get through it, you know. But what God had planned was that God, through my oldest boy, through my son, brought us to Harvest. October of 2012, when I sat in that back row at Harvest, there was something stirring in me that wasn't there before, or it'd been there a long time ago. All these brothers there were kept saying, get plugged in, get plugged in. That was the first time in my life when I had men walking lockstep with Christ stepped into my life. I don't think I was ready for all the accountability that was going to happen. On a Monday evening, I'm sitting in a small group, and my wife calls my son and said, you've got to talk to your father, because I can't take it anymore. I can't take the emails and the text messages and the sexting, and I can't take him saying that something's wrong with me, not wrong with him. And he called Dave Smoot while I was sitting there in men's group, and my brother Smoot called me out. What you doing, man? How you gonna tell somebody else how to live? How you gonna be an example to someone else when you, right now, you are faking it and not even trying to make it? And then God is like in my ear saying, okay, are you ready yet? Are you ready yet? I say, okay, all right. I was done. I was done keeping secrets. I was done hurting my wife. You know, I was done looking at pastors and brothers in the eye and knowing that I was still taking steps backward. Letting go of me was huge. I became more accountable to know that my wife now saw every email, every text, anything electronic. That's radically changed our marriage. It's been a journey. It's been a road. It's been rough, but it's so much better. 2014, I was diagnosed with glaucoma. They call glaucoma that the sneak thief of sight. My sight started to diminish pretty quickly. I mean, I've lost 95% in my left eye, and I've lost about 85% of my right, and that's slipping away. And I admit, there was part of me that said, wait, God, wait, now. I've just come back to you, all right? Now I'm going to lose my sight. What? I have cried, sobbed in my wife's arms at the thought of eventually, you know, not being able to see her face, or not being able to see the faces of my kids, my grandkids. Praise God, he said to me, no, my grace is sufficient, for my power is made perfect in weakness. I know that when I'm weak, I'm strong. I know that now. I've got a church where they've allowed me to serve, where I've been able to be held accountable, where I've got brothers in Christ that I can do life with. I have a beautiful wife whose face I've put lines in, and whose hair I've put gray in, and whose blue eyes I've diminished. I've got 7 amazing children, 4 of which have every reason in the world not to respect me or trust me or love me, and they do. There's no reason for me to be bitter. I'm better because I know I serve a God that is sovereign above all things. I'm better. Order my steps. Lead me where you desire me to go, and make it about you.